I've got a fun way to upgrade your Bezier Curve skills while using Tinkercad Sketch, so let's get cracking. To speed things up, we're going to start with a bit.ly. Please type bit.ly/hlpaint1 and press enter. This is the Sketch Painting Challenge. Of course, it is set to copy in Tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy in Tinker. Now, when you copy and tinker, you get an exact copy of my project. This one has three pieces done. There are notes that explain everything. They start up here. It mentions the sketch tool to paint, but I want to show you something else first. If in a browser tab, you type bit.ly/newHLMT23. It takes you to an amazing page where users share fantastic designs with me every day. So you can see here is where I made my project, and what I want to highlight today is that Landon already completed it. If we hit view in 3D, you can instantly check out his fantastic design. Once again, because he added the tag HLMT23, I was able to check it out and give a reaction to his fantastic creation. How cool is that? Of course, once you visit the link, make sure you check out the other fantastic designs that have been shared. As you can see, quick bonus tip, if you grab right here or just make a bookmark, you could add this to your screen and get to it immediately. Notice I have right-clicked and edited mine, so it just says HLMT23. I check this every day, and of course, reactions are always given. Note, sometimes I miss a design, like this popped up a few days ago and I didn't see it. If I ever do that, make sure you give me a few reactions, and that lets me know that I missed it. All right, let's return to the project. I'm gonna delete these pieces that I put in here. Notice there were three of them, and let me show you how we do it. So this is the sketch tool. I'm gonna bring it out, and I will set it in a 20 by 20 grid just to show you that's how big it is. For this project, it does not really matter though. If you've never used Sketch before, this highlights all the Sketch features. There are five different screens. They are animated and full of amazing tips. When you're done checking them out, you can always hit continue to sketch. If you prefer my tutorials, of course, I will have a link up here in the description, or you can simply use that bit.ly. So let me show you how to color something. First, we're drawing with straight lines. I want to make something that stays inside this dark area. I'm going to take my grid and shut it down to 0.1. That way I can get closer to where I want. And I'm going to fill in this door. We're simply going to click a straight piece. Notice it's going to cover all those holes. And then I'm going to switch to number two, which is Bezier Curve mode. If you go to the approximate middle, click, hold, and twist, you can make it follow that shape. I'm going to move down, click, hold, and twist for the next side. Now I can make a straightish line down here, or I can click, hold, and twist to get it sort of perfect, and then I can click to finish it. If you don't like what you did, of course you can delete it, but you can also double click, zoom in on the point, move it with arrow keys, or twist the handles. Now these are called smooth handles. Notice they both move. We've got three different options down here. Corner, smooth, and broken. You can use the shortcut keys. I'm gonna hit number three to make this a broken handle, and now only this one moves. That way you can get the exact shape you want. Once again, stretching them longer, rotating, twisting as you click, hold, and set it the way you want. I'm gonna click this corner real quick and hit number three. And I just wanna make sure that this pops outside this little spot a little bit more. And then I wanna show you that this one, I wanted it to be a line. So if I hit number one, bang, it does it that quick. Once again, with the arrow keys, I can nudge it a little lower. So let's hit finish sketch and see what we did. Check it out, we have got a door. If you take the height and set it to 1 millimeter and press enter, it matches our project. If you set it to 0.5, it sinks in, and all of a sudden the door is filled in with the color you choose. How cool is that? I think I'm gonna adjust this to 0.9. That way it still shows the details and I like the way it shows up. All right, so let's color another part. Because I've got the height on this one set perfect, I'm gonna do Control D. Let's double click to edit it, and then we're gonna delete that piece. We're gonna quickly do this piece right here. This time, once again, we're drawing with the pen tool, and we're just going to make a diamond that comes close to the outside of these edges. Once we finish it, double click to edit, and here's the cool part, double click to auto smooth. Bang! You have just filled in a window. Now, of course, we want a different color for the windows. Let's go to blues. I'm going to pick the one that I think looks pretty cool, and then I'm going to turn on transparent. Check it out. It actually looks like glass. Now, I want to use this window for the other windows. Let's double click to edit that. I'm going to zoom out, and I'm going to simply draw this window over here. P for pen. And this one will be straight lines. Bang. 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 And finish. Boom. Two windows in just a few moments. Let's do one more section right here. We're going to paint the middle of the house. We're going to use a little bit different trick. We are going to simply do Control D and double click. Zoom back out. Delete that piece right there. And this time we're going to draw half. So I'm going to start up here, come down to the middle, and I want to go around this window. So two for Bezier curve. Click the halfway mark-ish. If I get this straight up and down, notice it follows that line a little bit better. Once again, I'm going to click and get close. I want to go around this door too, because of course it's a different color. And then if I click, hold, and twist, follow it down to the bottom. Once again, we just want to stay inside these little lines, because that way it'll be hidden by the original color. Click up here, and then I'm going to click, hold, and twist to follow that bend. When I let go, you can see the half is pretty complete. We can double click to edit. Notice if you double click, it auto straightens or auto smooths. I don't want that for this, so I'm gonna do Control Z to go back. I'm gonna click on the one point I wanna mess with, hit number 3 to break it, and I just want it to get in to this area around that shape. Once again, same thing here. Hit number 3 to break those handles. Get this handle to go where I want. Number 3 here, of course, as well. Once again, we don't have to be perfect, but you just get it as close as you can, making sure that it's into the brown shaded area. I'm going to do number 3 here again so I can fix this really quick. But then, of course, this one, I'm going to hit number 1 to take it back to the line. So here's where it gets really cool. Click on that shape. Do Control C and Control V to make a copy. Make sure you've got the copy, move it to the other side, and then check the measurements. If you had shut your dimensions off, this is how you get them back. See how this down here says 16.10? Whatever number yours is, just make it the opposite. If I put negative and press enter, it flips my design. How cool is that? I can nudge them into place. Of course, this side was a little different, but watch this. We can double click, grab the point, and we just need it to be close to the area. Of course, we can just keep clicking on points and nudging them to the spots we want them. It makes the project so much quicker because you can copy and paste useful parts to the other side. I do want to remind you, if you click on a line, you can use the arrow keys to just nudge that to the spot you want. I'm going to click down here. Once again, those are in the way. So I'm going to click, hide, and nudge this into a spot that's a little better. I do see this is just outside. Don't forget, once you move it, use your Bezier curves to get them exactly where you want. And hit number 3 and bend this in so it goes inside the tan lines. Make this a little more precise with a nudge. And bang, let's see what we made. How cool is that? I'm gonna switch to a different brown just so it shows up a little better. All right, so here is your challenge, friends. Paint everything in here. Make the little bats look awesome. Give them faces. You can add different pieces to these as well. Maybe draw your own sketch hat for the ghost. Anything you want, make the grass green, the sky dark. But when you're done, you need to share it with me. Here's how. First, I'm going to tell you, go to settings, pick a background color you think is cool. Remember, Landon had the black background. If you shut off the shadows and the grid, when you click out here, that does look a little cooler. At that point, or when you're happy, we need to back out to the Tinkercad dashboard. Click on your design, click on the properties, Change the name to mention that it's your entry. I put HLModTech. Of course, add anything you want in the description. You can mention the tutorial. I'm going to paste this in here in a minute. And then add tags about your design. Of course, the important one is you have to have HLMT23 and press enter. Finally, make your design public. Up to you if you want to leave it share alike. You can also hit no derivatives. That way users cannot copy your design, but they can check it out. Once you hit save changes, and about 5 minutes later, there is my entry. Of course, as promised, reactions given. If you click on your HLMT23 page, it'll show up right there. So let's do a quick wrap up. Of course, this was just for fun. I showed you how to paint or practice and sketch. This one is just to show me what you did. Don't forget to tag it with HLMT23. Of course, don't forget, friends, that bit.ly up above leads to my sketch tool playlist. It is full of useful projects you can make with Sketch. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Of course, there are 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. A quick shout out to my Patreon supporters as well. Love how that group is growing. There are more than 250 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions and gain skills. And as a matter of fact, this idea was started by Benny. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the links in the description. Finally, friends, I want to say thanks to you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button or the hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.